my task this morning is to go a little deeper than the issue of the constancy of the constants and talk something about the very notion on which that is based, which is the laws of physics, and in particular, the origin of the laws of physics, a subject that many people consider to lie entirely outside the scope of science. Now, it's always good to start with a quotation by Einstein. This is a rather free translation, but he more or less said something like, "I want to know whether the good Lord had any choice in the form of his creation." What he meant by that is, could the universe have been different? Does it have to be as it is? And if it could be different, then why is it as it is? And so this very fundamental question is one that has fascinated me and many of my colleagues for my entire career. And it stems ultimately from two hidden assumptions. Sometimes they're not hidden, but mostly they're hidden, that all scientists must make when embarking on the scientific endeavor. And the first of these is that the universe is ordered in a rational and intelligible way. So we now talk about laws of nature, and people in this room like to think about them as really laws of physics, and that's an idealization of the general expectation that nature is not arbitrary or absurd, but is rational and intelligible, at least in part. And the idea that human beings could come to know how the world is put together and the rules on which it operates is an extraordinarily audacious idea. Why has this particular species on this particular planet evolved the capability of being able to grasp the hidden subtext of nature, the mathematical underpinnings on which the universe works? I still find that an extraordinary fact. We take science so much for granted these days that, of course, people expect it to work. That's what scientists do. They do science. And yet, the assumption that when we dig deeper and deeper into the workings of nature, we will find rational and intelligible order is an astonishing leap of faith. We take that leap of faith when we invest 8 billion euros in the Large Hadron Collider, in the expectation that even if we weren't to discover the Higgs boson, we would presumably discover something which made sense.